Welcome, everybody. You're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. Tonight, we will be working with Python and MySQL. As always, the code will be linked in the description below. We need to install mysqlconnect. We will create config files to store our user credentials for privacy. We need to make a connection to MySQL from Python. Then we will run a simple query, store it as a data frame for proof of concept. You, depending on your circumstance, can do a conda install of MySQL connector or the pip install or pip3 install, depending on the version of Python you are using. Feel free to stop the video and do that first. Okay? Then we're going to import mysql.connect. Then from mysql.connect, import mysql connection. Import pandas. For me, I created a file called python2mysqlconfig with a function called readdbconfig. Real quick, why I use these two right here. In the MySQL documentation, using connectors, you have two options, and it describes those here. You have the mysql.connector.connect, which is a function, or using the class version. This right here, we're going to use the class version first. Later, I'll show you the other version. Okay. We need to create our files. All right. So let's create this init file real quick. Okay. So let me create this. Use your editor of choice. I'm using Vim. I will call it config.ini. Okay, so what you need to do, is press I, use the brackets, and we're going to call MySQL, and then you need to establish your host. For me, I'm using localhost. Then you need your database you want to connect to, so your DB name, and then the username, which is your username, and then the password, which would be your password, if I could type today, okay? And that's it for this file. So then for me, I just use escape, colon, W for write, Q for quit. We got that file. Now we create our .py file, which will call our key value pairs for our credentials. I am calling mine python2mysql_config. Okay. So this one's going to be a little longer. So we'll do I for insert, and then we'll have to call a bash command. So then I'll have to say user bin slash python. If you have a virtual environment, you replace that line with that. Okay, so then we have to say from config parser import config parser. All right, define a function where we're going to call it read DB config, and we're taking in as parameters the file name, which would be your config file _.ini you just created, and then you're calling a section, and your section will be MySQL. Okay. And then you say parser.read your file name. And then you need to two. I'm doing two spaces for this so it's consistent, because you could get issues with it being inconsistent tabs or spacing. And then we need to create a if statement. So we're saying if the parser has the section of MySQL, which will be called section, then 2, 3, 4. Okay. Then we need to create items, which will be the parser dot items from our section. So we're basically taking our information, and we're going to create key value pairs. So then we have to iterate through that and say for item in our items, then we say let's make our keys, which will be 0 and then equals the, forgot the item, okay, and then now the value. So then we have to do our else statement, which will be raising an exception, where we need to say if our key is not found, or the value are not found in the file, then let's say take our section and our file name. Okay, let me make sure that's right. So I say raise an exception, and then format. Okay, that looks like it's correct. We'll find out in a second. And then we need to return our key value pairs. Okay, and then that's escape colon W to write, Q for quit, save that file. Now let's find out if this works. Okay, and we'll find out in a second down here. So you need to set up your connection, where I'm saying this read underscore db underscore config is our key value pairs. Okay, if you printed this off by itself, it would show you what that information is, but I'm not showing you that. And then you're using the double star here to take your quargs keyword arguments, and I'm using my class to make my connection. And then I'm establishing a cursor, which is allowing me to make my queries and retrieve or send data. All right. So let's see if it actually worked or if I made a mistake. Oh, looks like it worked. Then I want to start making proof of concept and running some queries. So I'll say take my cursor, and then it'll be execute, just like when we did some of our other videos. We'll say let's select everything from our table, which will be user underscore O, and let's limit this to, I don't know, 3. And then we need to fetch, and we have 3 options. So we have fetch one, fetch many, and fetch all. I'll just do fetch all because I only have a couple and I'm not storing it just yet. And here's what the entries look like. This is a fake credit card, fake email, the person's first, their last name, their phone number turned out kind of strange. We're gonna have to mess with that. And then this was a unique ID number. Okay, so I can show you here, that's what's going on. And I dropped this column because this was useless index column, because I forgot when I stored the file originally as a CSV to get rid of that. That's what's going on here. So here's our primary phone, but it looks odd right here, right? Turned out to be a float. So we got to take care of that, right? So here's the code for when I dropped the column. So I say, since I already have the table established, I say alter table, the table name, and the column I'm dropping. And then that'll drop it. Now we're going to fix our column or our data frame. So we're going to cut this real quick. We'll come down here. So we're going to take our query, and then let's just make up a name, and I'll just say, oops, this, and then let's fetch all. Let me store it as some variable. You can make it a useful variable name. And then what I need to do is say, well, let's create a let's create a data frame, right? So let's create a data frame from mm. Uh-oh. Where's my column names? So I need columns equal. And then you need to say my cursor dot column names. And there you go. Now you're good to go. Okay, cool. But then now let's mess with this. And let's change that thing up. Because that's pretty annoying, right? So let's just take this real quick. And then we'll say, let's just store it as, we'll just store it as mydf, and then we'll say mydf dot as type hold on there. I need to take the column, which is primary phone number dot as type int. So so that changes that, but let me see something in my original, something I was missing, I couldn't remember off the top of my head. This is the formatting that I was forgetting. Okay. There we are. Then you don't have to do this junk and just call a series. You're changing this specific column to this right here. This is more convenient. So it stores it, and you're not just doing a column once and then having to resave everything as a new variable. Good to go. Lastly, I wanted to mention this. If we're not using the class for the connection like I did above, and you're not storing user credentials, you can do this where you're taking the mysql.connector.connect. This may work or may not, this one right here. You may be able to get rid of that. Then you just say, if you don't care about hiding your user credentials, just put your user, your password, your host, and the database you're using to establish your connection. When you're done with all your function calls, always close your connection by doing connection.close like I had here. And you could just do that and then close the connection. So then what would happen is if you do this again, it's going to give you an error, right? It's because we lost the connection because I closed it off. And you'd have to go and hit the code above to do the connection once again. As always, I want to say thank you for watching. Please subscribe and turn on that notification bell. So like if you thought this video was useful content. If not, leave me a comment and tell me why so I could improve my channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.